Okay, this is going to be my first video, overlanding video blog. We had a faux pas. Me and my daughter Mariah did our rear brakes a couple days ago, replaced the rotor, repainted the calipers, caliper brackets, tightened on the bolts, new pads, etc., etc. And apparently one bolt did not get torqued properly enough. Not trying to place the blame on my daughter, and I don't remember if I did this side, the driver's rear, but somehow, me and my littlest one, we're going to go camping, and it's, like I said, Saturday, June 6th, about 10:38 now, and we started proceeding out about 6:30-ish, and going to go to Half Moon State Park over in Hubbardton to go camping for the weekend. And all of a sudden, I go to hit the brakes to slow down, and all of a sudden, there's a grinding noise that feels like the rear end was about ready to explode. So I get out, I look, and of course, it's the rear driver's tire locking up. I have no idea what's causing it, so I backtrack over by Green Dump in Castleton by Lake Bombazine, try to tear it apart, and notice that the one bolt is missing, and I have nothing for nuts or bolts or wires or anything. I took all that junk out of my truck, which was a mistake last year. And so a guy stopped, and I gave him the last bit of money in my wallet to help me look for a nut and bolt. And he had nothing, and he went on his merry way, and that was a waste of my money. And so we kind of tightened it down. After going to Aubuchon and Fairhaven, tapping on the glass, the lady there thought it was some kind of lunatic, like I was going to rob or rape her. Pillager, and when I opened up the store, wouldn't let me buy a bolt of the same size or anything. She was uncooperative, and so we inched it over to West Rutland, pulled in a Price Chopper where it locked up. I couldn't move forward, couldn't move back, so I tried to horse it. Right passenger's rear tire is spinning, the driver's rear tire is just dragging across the ground, and all of a sudden there was this loud pop. Big loud hissing sound, and needless to say, we put the caliper through the rim, the 17-inch aluminum wagon wheel rim, and I couldn't go anywhere, and so I got it jacked up, and about 7:38 o'clock, and it must have been 8:30-ish as it's getting dark, as you can see now, like this, at the other end of the park lot, way down there. a young gentleman named Lynn helped me jack up the tire. He had some mechanics wire stuffed an old 3/8 inch extension through the hole where the caliper bolt is about a half inch in diameter, if not 5/8. It looks like a metric thread. So with some mechanics wire and a 3/8 inch extension, it's holding it in place. We tightened down the top when he did, and then we went across the road to Stewart's over there. Got Aaron the spare, and my friend Randy showed up. Thank you, Randy, and thank you, Lynn. And we got the spare on, and that wasn't holding air. And, of course, we got out the Max Airflow MF-1050 to try to pump air up. That got us enough to get back over to Stewart's, and needless to say, I don't dare drive anywhere. And over in that neck of the woods, right over there, is Napa. But, unfortunately, Napa's closed, and it won't be open tomorrow, 8 o'clock. I could venture 5-10 miles up in the mountains to my parents, but it's up over three ridges. Do I dare chance it, have that bolt, that 3/8 extension fall out, the mechanics wire break, lose all braking control, lock it up, blow another rim? Or do I sit here and sleep in a Price Chopper parking lot like some kind of a vagabond, and then in the morning proceed over to Napa, and hopefully the guys in Napa, Chris Brown, and Paul, really good guys, Miss Foster working over there, can hopefully get me the bolt and get it tightened back down, torqued down, and be on my merry way. Maybe merry way. So it's about 10:45, and I'm getting tired. So it looks like we're crashing in the truck tonight. oh, wish us luck, guys. After 11 o'clock, just gonna fall asleep. There's a train off in the distance. It's a loud whistle. Yeah, I'll wake you up out of the sleep. You get the idea. I'm going back to sleep. Okay, it's like 12:30, 1 o'clock, whatever it is. A white Mercury Mountaineer Ford, whatever it is over there, just pulled up beside me. I don't know if they were going to look into my back of my trailer or thought I was not here or going to rob my truck. I don't know. But anyways, they pulled over there. They shut off their lights and they're over in front of Price Chopper. So if they're sleeping in their car, what they're going to do. But give me a little uneasy feeling here. It's 6:44 in the morning over there over that blue roof. That's Napa. Move to the other side of the parking lot. Get away from the lights. Napa opens at 7:30. Let me tell you, have you ever been truly bored? Well, I know what it's like.
Well, we have been stuck here overnight.
Yes, we have. And Napa can't open up anytime too soon for me.